10 days after 9/11, I went through the Pentagon and I saw Secretary Rumsfeld and Deputy Secretary Wolfowitz. I went downstairs just to say hello to some of the people on the Joint Staff who had used to work for me. And one of the generals called me and he said, "Sir, you gotta come in. You gotta come in and talk to me a second." I said, "Well, you're too busy." He said, "No, no." He says, "We've made the decision. We're going to war with Iraq." This was on or about the 20th of September. I said, "We're going to war with Iraq? Why?" He said, "I don't know." He said, "I guess they don't know what else to do." So I said, "Well, did they find some information connecting Saddam to Al-Qaeda?" He said, "No, no." He says, "There's nothing new that way. They just made the decision to go to war with Iraq." He said, "I guess it's like we don't know what to do about terrorists, but we've got a good military and we can take down governments." And he said, "I guess if the only tool you have is a hammer, every problem has to look like a nail." So I came back to see him a few weeks later, and by that time we were bombing in Afghanistan. I said, "Are we still going to war with Iraq?" And he said, "Oh, it's worse than that." He said, he reached over on his desk, he picked up a piece of paper, and he said, I just got this down from upstairs, meaning the Secretary of Defense's office today. And he said, "This is a memo that describes how we're going to take out 7 countries in 5 years, starting with Iraq and then Syria, Lebanon, Libya, Somalia, Sudan, and finishing off Iran." The truth is about the Middle East is, had there been no oil there, it would be like Africa. Nobody is threatening to intervene in Africa. The problem is the opposite. We keep asking for people to intervene and stop it. And there's no question that the presence of petroleum throughout the region has sparked great power involvement. Whether that was the specific motivation for the coup or not, I can't tell you, but there was definitely, there's always been this attitude that somehow we could intervene and use force.
Siete países en 5 años, ¿no? La
siete
cuenta,
países.
¿Ya cuánto lleva?
Eso fue en el 2007.
2007.
Y la intervención en Libia fue en el 2011. La intervención en Siria fue en el 2012. Y estamos, bueno, ante la canibalización de la política. Yo creo que si Thomas Hobbes estuviese vivo, estuviese en una pesadilla permanente, le hubiese metido 3 cachetadas a Obama. Thomas Hobbes y el Leviatán. Porque estamos ante eso. Se pasan a la ONU. El G20 se divide porque Rusia, China, India, Brasil, una serie de países que son una potencia económica, están diciendo, nosotros no vamos para la locura de Obama, pero países como España, ¿no? Como Japón, que lastimosamente algún día fue víctima y ahorita es victimario, pues obviamente está en esta arremetida en contra de los pueblos libres, señores. Señor Obama, usted no le presta atención que cuando usted bombardea hay niños, hay personas inocentes, que lo de Al-Qaeda es un doble rasero porque ustedes apoyan también a la gente de Al-Qaeda en este momento en Libia, porque las armas químicas las utilizaron ustedes. ¿En qué mundo estamos? Decía el presidente Chávez en el 2010 cuando le declaraba el amor a Siria. Y nosotros desde acá se lo seguimos declarando.
Sin duda.
Y seguimos reivindicando al pueblo sirio. Nosotros no podemos pasar como una especie de persona que está negada a la realidad porque, coño, aquí no está pasando nada en Latinoamérica,
no
está pasando nada.
No, pero...
Somos una sociedad paralela. Pero...